to get notified when I post my new videos. Today, I'll be discussing regarding a numerical of cantilever beam when it is subjected to the concentrated load. So I have two concentrated loads here. So one is 10 kilonewton and another is 5 kilonewton. So here I have the distance, the span distance of the AB, the span between A and B is 1.5 meter. So the distance or the span between B and C is 1 meter. So in this question, they have given that the L, the total length of the beam, they have given as 2.5 meters. The length of the overall beam they have given as 2.5 meter, wherein the distance between A to B here is 1.5 meter, and distance between B to C here is 1 meter. So, and then they have also given the two loads here. I just consider W1 as 10 kilonewton, that is concentrated load at first point, the point B, I have considered it as 10 kilonewtons, and W2 as 5 kilonewton. So I have just taken this, so wherein L is equal to 2.5 meter, the overall span, and W1 is the load at point B. So that is equal to 10 kilonewton, and W2 I have taken it as 5 kilonewton. So first step in our problem is, in our numerical, the first step here is I need to create the M by EI diagram. So creation of M by EI diagram. So creation of M by EI diagram. So I need to create the M by EI diagram. So I just start from the free end here. So at point C, I have the load of 5 kilonewton. So I have the load of 5 kilonewton at point C. So moment at point B due to the point C, that is 5 kilonewton, is equal to phi into 1. Moment at point B due to the load of 5 kilonewton is equal to phi into 1. So moment at B is equal to phi into 1. So that is equal to 5 kilonewton meter. So it is in clockwise direction. So therefore, I have taken here it as a negative variation. So therefore, it is minus 5 kilonewton meter. So as per my sign convention, I have taken it as right hand side. So, bending moment clockwise is taken as negative, and anti-clockwise is taken as positive. So, left hand side, so clockwise I have taken it as positive, and anti-clockwise is taken as negative. So, with this sign conventions, so I just take the moment at point B due to the 5 kilonewton load which is acting at C, as 5 into 1, which is equal to minus 5 kilonewton. So since it is a concentrated load which is acting, so bending moment variation for the concentrated load is linear variation. So therefore, since I have drawn a baseline here, so baseline below the the numericals or the moments which are negative, it should be drawn below the baseline, and which are positive, the moment values which are positive, it should be drawn above the baseline. So I have got it as minus 5, so it is below the baseline. So I have shown the linear variation here. So it is equal to minus 5. So next thing is, so So the next point is point A, wherein I need to find out the moment. So moment about point A. Moment about point A. So before or previous to the point A, you have two loads. So it is 10 kilonewton and 5 kilonewton. So that is a combination of the two loads, the moment. So total moment at point A is due to the loads 10 and 5 kilonewton. So it will be equal to, so it is equal to, so 5 into, so I just start from point C here. So 5 into the perpendicular distance between the point C to point A is 2.5 here. So therefore it is 5 into 2.5. So 5 into 2.5. So 5 into 2.5. So since it is a clockwise variation, as per my sign convention, right hand side, clockwise moment is taken as negative. Hence, I have taken this as negative. So again, I have left out with the second load, that is 10 kilonewton load. So the load into the perpendicular distance. So load is 10 kilonewton. The perpendicular distance between A to B is 1.5 meter. So it will be 10 into 1.5. So 10 into 1.5. So it is acting again in the clockwise direction. Hence, as per my sign convention, right hand side clockwise is taken as negative. So therefore, the overall value of the moment at point A is equal to 5 into 2.5 plus 10 into 1.5. So totally it will be 27.5 kilonewton meter. 27.5 kilonewton meter. So overall it will be a negative variation. So again, while drawing the M by EI diagram, so at this point, that is exactly at point A, if I just project this, so it is point A. So again, there are two loads wherein both are concentrated loads, wherein the moment variation is linear here. So just draw as a straight line here and then mention here it as 27.5 and this is 5. So as I said that it is M by EI, so it is 27.5 by EI and 5 by EI. So if I just project this point, so this will be, again, this will be 5 by EI. So the left out thing will be, it will be 27.5 and 5. So it will be 22.5 by EI. So this is the value. So this is the creation of M by EI diagram. So this is a creation for M by EI diagram. So the next step is I need to calculate the load at the free end. So while calculating the load at free end, so I need, as per my moment area theorem, so it is nothing but the area of the figure which is given. So step two, calculation of slope at free end. Why I have considered the slope at free end here is, so slope, as in case of cantilever beam, so deflection slope is maximum at the free end here. So I have considered it as free end. So you can also do it for point B also. So here, so theta is equal to, slope theta is equal to area of M by EI diagram, M by EI diagram. So theta is nothing but area of M by EI diagram. So here, I just refer to the M by EI diagram here. So let me consider this as 1, 2, and 3. So let me consider this as 1, 2, and 3. So area of M by EI diagram, it represents as the total area of summation area of 1, 2, and 3 geometrical shape of the figures. Okay. So here, I take it into consideration. So here, it is a triangle. So it will be half into. So base is nothing but the span between B and C. So here, base is the span between B and C. This is the distance. So it is equal to 1 into height. So half into base into height. Height here is considered to be as M by EI. So M here is 5 divided by EI. So it will be 5 by EI. So 5 by EI. So as I said that phi is the negative variation. So because it is in clockwise as per our sign convention, right hand side clockwise is taken as negative. So therefore, it is minus phi by EI. So I just go to the second figure here. So it is a rectangle here. So you can just straight away take that area as width into depth. So width here is the span between A and B. So plus width into depth. So it is width is 1.5. That is the span between A and B. And depth is again 5 by EI with a negative variation. So 1.5 into 5 by EI. So this is the second area. So again, I just consider the third geometrical figure here. So again, it is a triangle here. So therefore, it will be half into base here is the distance between A to B. So it is equal to 1.5, and then height here is, I can't take it as 27.5. Why I can't take? Because so it is between the base line and the overall moment. So it can't be considered because I need only between the reference point. I mean between 5 by EI to the top 27.5 by EI. So it will be the remaining distance, that is 22.5 by EI. So it will be minus 22.5 divided by EI. So this will be the overall value of the theta, that is slope at the free end. Slope at the free end, this is the value. So the overall, I have got it as 26.875 divided by EI. 26.875 by EI. So 26.875 by EI. So this is the value I have got. So in the question, they have not mentioned the value of EI. So if they mention the value of EI, you just substitute the value of the flexural rigidity over there and just simplify. Okay, so again, this is always in terms of radians. This is always in terms of radians. So also, I have mentioned the overall as minus 26.875 by EI. So otherwise, you can also take it as 26.875 by EI radians in clockwise direction. So the next thing is, I need to calculate what is the deflection. So here, so deflection I need to calculate. So step three, I need to calculate the deflection. So calculation of deflection calculation of deflection at free end. Calculation of deflection at free end. So I need to calculate the deflection at free end. So it is given by delta. So it is given by delta. So can just take it as delta subscript C. Why? Because the free end point is C. So therefore, deflection at point C is equal to delta C. So therefore, I can take it as delta C. So it is nothing but moment of M by EI diagram, of M by EI diagram, moment of M by EI diagram about C. Moment of M by EI diagram about C. So that can also be taken as area into, so that can also be taken as area into centroidal distance. Centroidal distance. So that can also be taken as area into centroidal distance. So area, so as I said that I have divided it into three geometrical figures here. So that I have taken it as 1, 2 and 3 here. So first area will be half into, same as this, 1 into minus pi by EI. So into the distance here. So the distance from the point C I have supposed to consider. So if I just draw the reference, I mean the centroidal point here. So this is my reference point. So from here, the distance between centroidal point to that of the reference point will be equal to 2/3 of base. So 2/3 times of base here is the distance between B and C. So 2/3 of 1. 2/3 of 1. So the next is the second figure is the rectangle here. So it is plus area will be 1.5 into minus pi by EI. And then if I just draw the centroidal point here, so it is the distance from the centroid to the reference point. So it is from here, from point C to B, it is 1. So again, from B to A, I have 1.5, but centroid will be half of this 1.5. So therefore, it will be 1 plus 1.5 by 2, the centroidal distance. So the last sketch is that sketch 3, that is I need to calculate what is the area for, what is the area, I mean moment for the third figure. So it is again plus, the area will be as it is, half into 1.5 into minus 22.5 by EI. So if I just project this, so it will be the reference point is C here. So reference point is C. So the distance between C to this point, so centroidal point. So I know the distance between B to C is 1 meter. So the distance between B to C is 1 meter. So here, the distance between B to A is 1.5. But since it is a triangular figure, the triangular variation, so the centroidal distance will be 2/3 of 1.5. So therefore, it will be equal to 1 plus 1.5 times of 2/3. 1 plus 1.5 times of 2/3. So 1 plus 1.5 times of 2/3. So therefore, it will be equal to, so therefore it is equal to, that overall deflection is equal to, once again, therefore the overall deflection is equal to minus 48.54 divided by EI, or it can also be equal to, since the value of EI here it is given as a constant, so therefore it can straight away taken as 48.54 divided by EI in the downward direction. So minus represents the deflection is in the downward direction. As in case of negative sign, in case of the slope, it represents it as the clockwise variation. Thank you.